Since its beginnings in 1970, UNCG's Residential College has attempted to combine educational innovation with some of the better features of traditional college programs. The result is a program of studies that stresses connections among classes and encourages students to be actively involved. Residential College strives for a sense of community among its members. Students and faculty participate together in committees, retreats in the mountains, athletic competition, and picnics. Activities of the College Center in Mary Faust Hall, where RC students, mostly freshmen and sophomores, live and learn together. Classes, workshops, and other groups meet in seminar rooms and parlors in the dorm. This residence hall is also special in that it is co-educational. A faculty couple who serve as counselors reside there, and some faculty members have offices there. Students come to know each other well and have opportunities to develop close personal ties with university faculty. I'm Scott Carper, and on our show today is the director of the Residential College, Dr. Murray Arndt. How you doing, Murray?
Very good, Scott.
Welcome to the show. Talk a little bit about what Residential College is.
Well, as you were saying, it is a kind of experimental college in which students are encouraged to make their education a sort of whole unit. That is not simply an accumulation of classes and courses, but an education in which their social life is as important as their academic life, and all of it is a part of making them whole, educated persons, eventually.
And how has this gone about?
Well, obviously the first component of the experiment is the fact that we teach classes in a dormitory, so that students living in Mary Faust dormitory attend their classes there, or the large percentage of them. They attend class with people whom they know from daily living, and they attend classes with faculty members who spend a good deal of time in the dormitory, outside of class, in fact.
Mm-hmm. How was Residential College started, and how long ago?
Well, it was started, as we had in the introduction, sometime around 1970, and perhaps you can remember that 1970 was a pretty unstable time in terms not only of education, but of the nation, a time of the Vietnam War and peace movements and great civil rights movements, Kent State deaths, Jackson State problems, so that even this university, as conservative and stable as it seems, was in 1970 in considerable disruption. There were a lot of sit-ins, administrative offices were closed, classes were canceled on a number of occasions, and students were by and large questioning what the institution of the university was doing for them in terms of education. That, I think, precipitated Dr. Warren Ashby's idea that 1970 was an appropriate time to carry out a kind of experiment in education in which some very different ways of learning, some very different ways of attending the university could be introduced into the lives of some university students. So in 1970, Dr. Ashby got a number of faculty, 10 or 12 faculty, together, and we planned out a course of procedures to incorporate these ideas and these experiments into some working unit, and it eventually was the unit that is called Residential College.
How did it develop through the years to, you know, present day, 1987?
Well, I suppose that if students who were attending the Residential College in 1971, when it first opened, were to come to the Residential College now, they would say that an awful lot has changed, that it has gotten much more conservative, that it has gotten much more institutionalized, That it has been adopted by the administration as a kind of fair-haired child and gotten a lot of gifts and support. And they would remember that most of the energy that was residential colleges in the beginning came from its being an antagonistic movement. That is, from its being very much disliked by the administration. Without much support at all, and students constantly feeling that it was incumbent on them to be better than other students or the place was going to be closed next week. It was kind of an epitaph that hung over our doorways, behave or tomorrow you may go, and it was something that we knew very well. And that kept us kind of energized. There was the enemy, the big university out there, that kept us very alive and vital and made us better than we were. Now, when I say, well, all that has changed, it has changed to a great deal, to a great extent. But in fact, there are an awful lot of things about residential college that have remained the same. I mean, we have alternative course. Schedulings for students. They don't take the same kind of curriculum that students ordinarily take. Their courses are much more intended to mesh one with another so that, well, for instance, I was talking to one of my advisees today and she was simply amazed that all the material that she was learning in one course was relating to material that she was learning in another course and in a third course. So that, in fact, the thing was working for her, at least. Now, for some people, it simply doesn't work. I mean, it is not a panacea or a cure-all of all educational problems, but I think it is an experiment that turned out very good.
Looking back in the early 70s, you can see what kind of students you were attracting back then, the antagonistic type that wanted the fight, wanted something different. What kind of students are you attracting today?
Now, that's a very interesting question because it's a question that I keep posing to myself. Because in fact, it is true that we attract a very specific kind of student. In fact, all of our students must self-select themselves. They must, as seniors in high school, decide that they are not only going to go to a specific university, but from the first day that they're here, they're going to follow a very specific and, in some ways, mysterious and slightly unexplained kind of program. They're risking a lot, I think, and that may be one of the characteristics. And one of the very best characteristics that most of our students have is that they are not afraid. A lot of them have come from sort of experimental work in high school, from advanced work in college credit courses, schools within schools, things of that sort. And they are used to taking risks and experimenting with things. So that's one characteristic they have. The other thing I think is that most of them are better verbally than they are mathematically. Now, I don't know why that should be, but the very fact I think that people have to sit down and write out essays in order to enter this kind of program perhaps sort of self-selects them as verbally oriented so that we don't get, to our sorrow, a lot of good scientists or mathematicians.
Let's talk a little bit about the courses that are being offered in RC. You've talked about alternative courses as such. What kind of courses is exclusive to residential college that the students cannot, reach in the university itself?
Well, let me begin with something that most university students would understand, that is a core course. I mean, the fact that almost all university students at UNCG now have to take Western Civ is a kind of model for something that happened in residential college first, in fact, that we insisted that all our students had to share one course during the whole four semesters that they were at residential college, and that is what we call our core course. Now, in the beginning, in fact, that was a Western Civ course. But when the university decided to require Western Civ, there wasn't much point in an experimental college offering the same thing that the university was doing. So we changed our core course now, and for four semesters, all of our students, for one course, take a course in American Studies for four semesters, and they all share that course. And it's a combination of large lectures and small mm-hmm. seminars, and a very productive course.
Briefly, talk about Valley Cruces, your retreat to the mountains that we talked about.
Yeah, that obviously is a basically non-academic thing, but one of the things that we try to insist on is that our students sort of form themselves into a kind of community in which they can learn together. And in order to do that, we do some things outside of class together, like going to the mountains, to Valley Cruces near Boone. And we spend two long weekends a year at Valley Cruces and have some of our most successful
Sounds like a very interesting experience. In addition to having the on-campus stuff, they
yes.
have the chance to go away with the whole dorm and everything.
Yes.
Well, I really appreciate you coming and talking to us. Dr. Murray Arndt of the Residential College, Director of the Residential College.
Thank you.
Thank you, Murray.